The next thing to do will be to form a pad, which is going to create the first of our fan blades. After that, we can use that pad to multiply around the number of blades using the patterning tool. So the first thing I do, all of our sketches until now have been on the YZ plane. We're now going to need to create something which comes out between the hub and the outer ring, and I'm going to suggest that in this instance we sketch it on the YZ plane. So if I go pad, sketch icon, and the YZ plane, and if we look at it, I think ideally the fan would be capturing air on the bottom side here and pushing it out the back, and you'll see why in a minute. So the first thing I'm going to do is I want to create some sort of a shape that's going to create this pad, but it can't be any wider than the hub that's there or the outer ring, which is here. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to choose the spline tool to draw something. I might just zoom in a little bit so I can see what's going on. I'm now going to grab the spline tool and capture something which I think looks a little bit like a fan. I'm going to finish drawing that by double clicking. I click off and draw another spline here, and to create this foil shape. And then now, in order to enclose that object, I need to join these two up with a straight line. So I grab the straight line drawing tool and I coincide there and there. To finish that one off, I grab the line drawing tool again and finish off this one and this one. And now when I exit out of the workbench, let's have a look and see what that looks like. So at the moment, we've got what is looking like the beginning of a fan blade. If we preview that, that looks a bit like a fan blade. We can then extend that out to up to next. So let's see what that does for us. No, that's not working very well. Up to last. There we go. Try that. So I'm going, so if I preview that, we've got something that looks a lot like a fan blade now. Now I think what we might find is that at the moment the fan has come all the way into the center of our hole, so we're going to have to get rid of that also. So what we do now is we click on this button here which says more, and we go up to next, and I think you'll find if we zoom in there, we've now no longer have that blade coming through there. So there we have the first of our fan blades.